I like my hat.
It's good.
Yeah.
You look good too.
I think I do. Yes. I think I might adopt this look.
Yes.
Is there a reason why you have a black hat and I have a white hat?
We can wear any color you like. So I bought this. I like it myself because I like the color.
There is a lot of tension in the last 5 years or so. Is Islam a threat to Dutch values?
Islam is preaching above all peace. Peace, peace, and peace.
من خلال قول المصطفى صلوات الله وسلامه عليه لا تقوم الساعة حتى يقاتل المسلمون اليهود فيقتلونهم.
The name Islam means peace.
And yet it is involved in a lot of war and violence.
Yeah, it's just all politics.
Nothing to do with religion?
No, no.
No?
No, sir.
It's a political.
It's a politics.
It seems to be a lot of passages that say the infidel is not the equal of the believer. The infidel will die in hell. Don't feel bad about hating the infidel.
No.
No? Boy, I've got bad information.
Yes, you have. I think so.
You think that
no,
means...
No, 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 no.
No, 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 no.
No, no, no,
no. 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 I'm wrong about everything.
The way I perceive things in the Quran is not about killing infidels or...
But you have read it
...or homosexuals.
There.
Of course I read the Quran.
And you've read those passages.
Yeah, I've read those passages.
And what did you think when you
no,
read them?
No, but I explained those passages within the time in which they emerged.
But that's
in the world.
Not how people read holy books. People
no.
don't read holy books and go, but, well, that was good for then. People read
no,
holy books
think,
and go, this is
I
the word
agree.
Of God, it's forever.
No, I don't
that's
agree.
How most people
no,
do
no,
it.
No, I don't agree.
I just don't buy it that these guys are in this state of denial. I think they're just in a state of denial to an outsider.
Right.
They will not admit anything is wrong with their culture to an outsider. Muslims were imperialists in the century after Muhammad's death. They conquered most of the known world in one century.
No, yeah, it is possible that you call it conquer. I think they were trying to spread Islam.
Well, they were, but they yeah. weren't doing it by singing Kumbaya.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Oh, that 21st century always busting
yeah,
in.
I'm going to shoot it
off. I love it that he's got Kashmir as his ringtone.
Okay. I shoot it off. Yeah.
Sorry, I'm.
Yeah, it is just all politics.
Politics. Okay.
Bill, you are not so smart.
You think it's possible that when we're on something like marijuana or mushrooms, and we believe we're having a very spiritual experience, that we're just high?
It's.
Oh, look out! Your head's on fire. Wait, talk about the light bulb going off. That was your whole head.
I don't like candles behind me.
No. Yeah. Look, I found another joint.
Uh-oh.
Can we get closer? That is one hell of a wall. This is the Dome of the Rock.
This is the Dome of the Rock. According to Islam, this is the place where Muhammad the Prophet stood before he fly to meet God in the heavens. After
on a
he
horse.
Finished, yeah. After he no no, the horse was out of. He had the horse where the woolen wall, the
well,
western
I thought
wall.
He went
he lifted
to heaven on
there.
The horse.
Yes.
Why
I mean,
is it holy for the Jews?
Because the rock was part of the temple. I just want you to go down the rock to take a look. For 1 minute,
yes,
just to
yes.
take a look from inside. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Please. The direction of prayer, you know. Because you every time when you put yourself and start your prayer, you have to know exactly how to face the Kaaba in Mecca.
Right. A rock. The Kaaba?
No, no, no.
No, no. Isn't that?
No, no, no.
Oh.
Black stone.
Stone
yeah,
rock.
Black,
I think of
we
the same
know
thing.
We don't know the history of this stone.
Why is
the
that?
Muslims believe
holy.
That this stone came from paradise, from
paradise.
The heavens.
Could the rock itself have been what we now know to be like a meteor.
It's black. And in the area, there's no black stones.
But does it make a difference that we now understand what a meteor is?
This is the stone of
yes,
God.
Yes, right. Okay. This is the Mount of Olives. A lot of Orthodox Jews want to be buried here because they believe that when the Messiah comes, he will raise them from the dead and march them through that golden gate and onto the Temple Mount, which is why the Muslims have walled up the gate, the better to keep out the Jewish Messiah and his kosher zombies from getting in. Although you'd think that if you had the power to raise the dead, you'd have the power to jump a fence.
I can't be inside because I am a Muslim.
I thought I would not be allowed to walk in a mosque. I thought only someone of your faith was allowed to do that.
No, in Islam, we are enough tolerant to accept the fact that non-Muslims are able to be inside, to take a look, to have a short stroll, or to ask questions.
Why is he angry?
This is what I expected, you know.
You're angry that you're talking to me?
Yes.
Women in your culture seem not to be as equal to the man as they are in our culture.
Okay, you see, we have women here.
Yes.
They have a special corner.
I talked to a Muslim scholar today, and he said that Muhammad had a meeting here.
When Muhammad landed here, he met with other prophets, with Moses, with Jesus, with Abraham, and others.
Muhammad never stepped his foot on that Temple Mount, not even one foot, never in the land of Israel. That's a historical fact.
You know, for Muslims, you cannot hesitate. You have to accept every letter, every word in this story.
I think even I understand that. Why can't the people of the different faiths get along? All three religions consider the same site to be holy. Is it not because it was conquered many times? It was conquered first by King David, and then later by the armies coming out of the Arabian desert.
We have the Romans, we have the Byzantines, we have the Persians.
There's more than one mosque in the world that used to be a church, and before that was a temple, because it's a lot easier just to change the sign on the top and say under new management than it is to change the whole building. I worked a lot of comedy clubs in the 80s that still had the disco ball on the ceiling. And in the 90s, they became strip clubs. And now there are Starbucks. I've come today to the village of Cernobbis in southern England to show you something completely different. It's in the shape of a giant naked man with a sizable erection. Well, sizable for England. Some people think that this means that there is a giant actually buried under that hill. Others think it has something to do with crop circles or ancient space visitors or druids. But nobody really knows. And that's what I find fascinating about this, is that it doesn't really mean anything. The locals have been maintaining it for centuries, and they don't really know why. They just do it because they've always done it. And isn't that religion for you? Sometimes you kneel, sometimes you fast, and sometimes you go up on the hill and you cut the grass around the giant space penis. You believe, as so many Christians do nowadays, that the world will end?
I think we are in the end times.